Marketing mix, the four P's. The marketing world has changed drastically in recent years, mostly due to the advent of the internet. This has allowed people new ways to buy, search, collect, and learn. The world of marketing has changed drastically, and companies have had to readapt to it. Prior to the eruption of the internet, companies used to create products, test the pricing model, distribute them, and promote them without any solid theory, but simple trial and test. Even though this theory, raised by Philip Kotler in 1967, may seem incomplete by nowadays standards, it is still the basis of modern marketing. So, what are the four P's and in what way are they still valid? The great value of Kotler's theory was to obtain an initial scheme from which it has been possible to develop a whole modern science known today as marketing. This model answers four key questions: what product, at what price, where will it be placed, and what promotion will I use? Product. The product is anything that you can offer to the market for acquisition use or consumption, and that can satisfy a need or desire. A product is a sum of characteristics or physical attributes. It is defined based on market knowledge and the behavioral characteristics of potential customers. It is key to highlight the characteristics, attributes, and or benefits in order to allow identification in the market, differentiate it from the competition, and achieve a brand positioning. Thus, it is important to define our product to study four key elements: product portfolio, product differentiation, brand, and presentation. The different levels of products can be determined as such: essential product, the sum of benefits for the user; tangible product, the sum of formal aspects such as characteristics, brand, packaging, style, quality, or design; an increased product, the sum of added aspects such as credit, delivery terms, warranty, after-sales service, financing, maintenance, and installation. Consequently, when considering the product, any good entrepreneur should ask themselves the following questions: what does the customer want from the product? What needs does it satisfy? What features does it have to meet these needs? Are there any features that you missed out? Are you including costly features that the customer won't actually use? How and where will the customer use it? What does it look like? How will customers experience it? What is the size, color, etc.? What is it to be called? How is it differentiated versus your competitors? Price. This is the amount of money that you pay to buy a product or service. It is a key factor as of demand and therefore essential in the company's marketing. It is one of the basic elements that allows to obtain benefits or determine the eventual failure of the company. The price is established from a series of different calculations and economic studies, where we will identify the demand for our product, competitive prices, consumer purchasing power, current trends, and the likes of the aforementioned consumers. By joining all these factors, we will fix the price of our product. It is also essential that companies take into account different forms of payments or discounts that may be susceptible of future application to your product. The price is an element that is fixed in the short term and the only one of the four from which we will generate income. When defining the price, it is necessary to take into account costs, fixed and variable, profit margin, internal and external environment elements, marketing strategies, and strategic and tactical objectives. For the person in charge of marketing in the company, price is a powerful competitive tool, since offering low prices can revolutionize the market. Since marketing is the only tool that provides income, as it is an instrument that causes significant psychological reactions on the consumer, price must be adaptable to the consumer depending on how they value the product. Consequently, when considering the price, any good entrepreneur should ask themselves the following questions. What is the value of the product or service to the buyer? Are there established price points for products or services in this area? Is the customer price sensitive? Will a small decrease in price gain you extra market share? Or will a small increase be indiscernible and so gain you extra profit margin? What discounts should be offered to trade customers or to other specific segments of your market? How will you price compared to your competitors? Placement. The placement is the instrument of marketing that matches the production with the consumption. The objective is to put the product at the disposal of the customer. It includes distribution, information, promotion, and or product presentation at the point of sale. The user must be able to access the product at any time, so it is important to establish the strategic points where the product will be marketed beforehand. Therefore, it is indispensable to make up a solid distribution strategy where certain aspects have to be considered. Distribution channel. This is the medium that allows the product to get the producer to the consumer directly or through an intermediary. The types of channel. Direct channel. The manufacturer offers the product or service directly to the consumers. It has the advantage that the producer has direct contact with the leading end of the purchase. You can vary the price, gather first-hand information, find the taste of the consumer, and thus can make a most appropriate argument. As a drawback, it has a higher cost since potential buyers are dispersed. Indirect channel. The manufacturer uses intermediaries to bring products to the final customer. It has the advantage of a wider and extended distribution, and there is no need to know the local market. However, there is the disadvantage of a loss of control in the distribution process. Consequently, when considering the placement, any good entrepreneur should ask themselves the following questions. What do buyers look for your product or service? If they look in the store, what kind? A specialist boutique or in the supermarket? Or both? Or online? Or direct via catalog? How can you access the right distribution channels? Do you need to use a sales force or attend trade fairs or make online submissions, send samples to catalog companies? What do your competitors do and how can you learn from that and or differentiate? Promotion. Promotion refers to raising customer awareness of a product or brand, generating sales and creating brand loyalty. It covers the methods of communication and the marketer uses to provide information, both verbal and visual, about their product or service. In order for it to be successful, it has to be communicated clearly to the target market. There are several methods to achieve such purpose. Some of the most popular ones are stated below. Advertising, communication through mass media. The firm will usually pay for this type of communication. Public relations, developing a positive relationship between the organization and the media and the public. Good public relationships involve not only creating favorable publicity through the media, but also involves minimizing the impact of negative situations. Sales promotion, promotions designed to create a short-term increase in sales. Examples of sales promotion include money off coupons, discount codes, and flash sales. Personal selling, sales interaction between the firm's representative and the consumer on one-to-one basis. Direct mail, post and email. This involves sending marketing to a named individual or organization. Firms often buy lists of names, emails, and postal addresses for this purpose. This can be highly effective when the direct mail recipients are within the firm's target market. Internet marketing, placing adverts on internet pages through programs such as Google's AdWords. Social media, firms place daily messages on social media such as Facebook and Twitter to keep customers interested in their organization. They may even run promotions, flash sales, and discounts just for the social media readers. Sponsorship. An organization or event is paid to use your branding and logos. Sponsorship is commonly used in sporting events. Players, clothing, and stadiums will be covered in the firm's branding, and even the tournament may be named after the firm. Although effective sponsorship requires a large audience, you may get smaller firms interested in local business sponsoring small events in their area, for example, school fairs. Firms need to carefully consider the message that their promotion strategy will be conveying to their target audiences. What message will promotion activity send to the target audience and how will it impact the firm's reputation? The promotion's message should reinforce product benefits and help the firm to develop a positioning strategy for their products. Thus, the company must take into account their leadership and general behavior of their target audience, as targeting through effective media campaigns could save the company valuable financial resources. Consequently, when considering promotion, any good entrepreneur should ask themselves the following questions. Where and when can you get across your marketing messages to your target market? Will you reach your audience by advertising online, in the press, or on TV, radio, or on billboards? By using direct marketing method, through PR, on the internet? When is the best time to promote? Is there seasonality in the market? Are there any wider environmental issues that suggest or dictate the timing of your market launch or the timing of subsequent promotions? How do your competitors do their promotions, and how does that influence your choice of promotional activity?